26-year-old Urbandale man is in a medically induced coma tonight after a beating outside a Des Moines sports bar. Amanda Lewis shows us why neighbors and bar owners are fed up with this violence.
Well, Stacy, Marcus Mullinger isn't awake yet to answer questions, but the owners of Score Sports Bar say he was causing problems inside the bar before the beating outside.
Score Sports Bar looks safe enough during the day. Sometimes at night, neighbors say things get out of control.
Sometimes it's terrifying.
Early Sunday morning was one of those times. A man was beaten outside the bar. He's now in a medically induced coma.
He was bleeding from his head and his face and his ears.
The bar and area around it have been visited by police at least 8 times over the past 6 months. Most calls involved assaults. Bar staff didn't want to talk to us on camera, but wrote this on the bar's Facebook page. We are tired of crime and violence in our community. It only takes a few cowards to shine a bad light.
The owners of the sports bar may be tired of the violence, but so are the neighbors. And they blame the bar for attracting the violence.
A lot of cars, fighting, yelling, screaming, drug deals go on. And you're getting scared to even go outside with your kids.
The bar has a troubled history. In May of 2000, a man was shot in the bathroom. In September of 2003, a woman was shot in the back. In January of 2004, a man was found shot to death in the parking lot. Back then, it was called Tommy's Hickman Pub. Des Moines police say the number of calls to the bar has gone down since it changed names and management.
I don't think it's considered a problem bar by any means.
The owners have offered security video and any other assistance they can. Police say they've been very cooperative, and police tell us they are close to an arrest.
This afternoon, I received an email from owner Ron Williams. In it, he said, Score Sports Bar makes every effort to keep confrontations and violence out of our establishment by implementing security measures as every responsible bar owner should. Our measures consist of a security staff, cameras, a no-tolerance policy, and an age restriction of 25.
And Amanda, do we know anything about the victim tonight?
Not a whole lot, but police say they found a permit to carry a concealed weapon inside his vehicle, along with weapons, marijuana, and drug paraphernalia. Probably some of the other things they're going to want to talk to him about once he wakes up.